Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of What the Heck is Steve Talking About? Today, we're going to do three really short videos to wind up Mary Romero's IET 432 Electrical Controls of Hydraulics class. So I've got a few diagrams I'm going to post. It's actually going to be three different videos. They're going to be short, I promise. They're short and sweet. It's kind of some cool circuits. So let's get this thing wired up. All right, so here we go. Here's the electrical diagram, our ladder diagram. That's it's a hydraulic pressure switch circuit. It's a pretty simple one. You can see we've got the basics right on the first rung. We've got our stop switch, which feeds right into our start switch, and that immediately feeds our control relay number one. And then you can see the seal-in circuit here, so we don't have to hold the button down. Keep the circuit running. And once we do hit the start button, solenoid A is going to activate. And I've labeled that DCV/cylinder because it's going to run a DCV that activates a cylinder. And what happens is the rod's going to extend, and you can go down to rung number 3, and you can see control relay 1 B is going to close, of course, when we hit the start button. But the rest of that line isn't going to be activated until the cylinder extends and hits limit switch number 2. And then we've even got another pause for a moment while the pressure builds up. And then we're going to activate solenoid B, which is a different DCV altogether. And it's going to let the motor run. So it's a pretty cool little sequence circuit. And really what it does is it ensures that the cylinder extends before the motor runs. It gives us a couple of safeties in there, actually, the limit switch and the pressure switch. The pressure switch, keep in mind, doesn't even come into play until the cylinder is extended and closes limit switch number 2. So it's a pretty cool little circuit. Let me show it to you and we'll make it run. Okay, so once again, smash the wires here, but I promise it lines up with the wiring guide that I just got done posting for you. And let's go over a couple things. Here's our stop switch, right? Which is wired into our start switch that is also sealed in. Here's our control relay. And you can see we're only using one relay. Relay B is not being used. And then when we get down to the hydraulics, we've got this rod that's being controlled here by this DCV, right? And here's the cool part. The second step of this doesn't work until the rod extends and closes this circuit here. Once this limit switch gets closed by that rod being activated, then that gives this pressure switch the opportunity to read the pressure. And when the pressure builds up, this switch allows the other DCV to activate, which will then in turn run that motor. It's pretty simple stuff. Let's give it a crack. All right, let's turn this guy on. Here we go, I'm gonna hit the start button. All right, we're coming out pretty slow. When it reaches the end, there should be a pause before that motor starts. And there was, right? Let's try that one more time. That guy's gonna retract. So again, this rod's gonna come out pretty slow, right? But that motor is not gonna run until that limit switch is made and the pressure switch sees pressure. Okay, pretty simple. That's a pretty easy one. So, like I said, that was going to be a short one. It's just a simple little, it's a neat little circuit, right? A couple little things in there that, a couple safety features. The motor cannot run until the limit switch is activated by the rod. And the pressure switch has to sense a buildup of pressure, and then the motor can run. So it's a nice little sequencing circuit. So that's it. That's a short one. Wraps it up. Let's get on to the next one. Thanks for watching.